It's 4 o'clock on a Tuesday. You know what that means, don't you? It's time for another exciting episode of Taxi's Quarantini Happy Hour. Woo! Yeah, baby. And thank you, fake audience. Thank you, fake band. Oh, yeah, I don't need both of these in yet. Hello. Let's say hello to everybody in the chat room. See what's going on in there. Fader Man is about to show up with his mighty roadcaster. Yeah, it was almost late for the show. I was sitting there trying to suss out this problem with the weird, like, tunnel-y effect, and I can't figure it out. Hello, Martin Gravel, Dan Weber, Jesse J. Peck, El Rosso Emil, Robert Orzechowski, Edmund Red, Nancy Kalel, Riffs That Rule, Darren Fletcher, Songs From a Headband, Spiritual, Bob Gunnerfelt, Marion Laird. Hello, everybody. So, yeah, took the day off yesterday. Hello, Jay Williams and Peter Rahill, Alex Dillon, Aaron Northern, Jesse J. Peck. Deb and I went to Santa Barbara for a romantic little overnight because it was our anniversary the other day, and I've got a birthday coming up, so we figured we'd go to a swanky little resort using some Taxi Road Rally miles I got from, I think, 2 years ago. They give me, points or whatever for being the taxi boss at the Road Rally. So we cashed it in, and thank you very much, guys. Went to a beautiful resort, had a very relaxing 30 hours out of the house, watching a bunch of people walk around a fancy resort with masks on. I'm not telling anybody when my birthday is, just because I don't want anybody to know. It's more about security issues, having somebody know my birthday, and, you know, there's so much else you can find out about me online. Anyway, but I will tell you that it was our 28th anniversary, and we have been together now for 30 years. I can't believe that Deb has put up with me for 30 years. So that was, yeah, kissing with masks on sucks. It was, you know, not uncomfortable. I got to say, the resort, it's a fairly large resort, and it was pretty full. And there were people all over, people eating outside, like on patio restaurants, without their masks, but wearing their masks everywhere else. We spent a lot of time walking around, up and down the beach, went for a really long walk on Sunday on that beach. And then yesterday went on a nature walk through the foresty area and ended up on a cliff overlooking the Pacific. And we had, some form of hawk, red-tail hawk, whatever, big hawks that were circling, and they were like eye level with us. We must've been a couple hundred feet over the water, I guess. Now, no time to go fishing. We did hang out for probably half an hour to an hour on that cliff looking out, and a lot of sargassum and other forms of seaweed, whatever the form of seaweed with the little bubbly things that keep it afloat. I don't know if this is true on the West Coast, but on the East Coast, especially in Florida and the Caribbean, anytime you see that kind of weed, there are usually bait fish under it. And where there are bait fish, there are bigger fish going for them. Often that means dolphin, as in mahi-mahi, not like, not flipper. No snook. It was relaxing. We didn't feel like we were going to get infected the whole time. Actually brought a bunch of wipes with us. The room actually supplied some wipes. And as soon as we walked in, I wiped down like the telephone, every doorknob, the toilet flushing handle, the TV remote about four times. Anything that you would touch, I wiped down. My wife is just like rolling her eyes. But you know what? So be it. Actually got a very long text message from a good friend of ours whose entire family, like eight of them, two of them did not get infected, but six out of the eight did get infected with the coronavirus. back in June, and they actually made it onto a TV show. The grandfather of the family is close to 80 years old. He is obese. He's got diabetes. He's got just about everything wrong. I think he's a cancer survivor. Everything wrong with him that would tell you that this is a man who probably, well, big helicopter flying over. Basically, none of them had anything more than basically a cold, which, thank God, you know, lucky them. They actually were not happy with the way they were being treated by the doctors. They found another doctor, I think on the East Coast, and talked to them online or something and ended up prescribing a drug I had not heard of. What do they call that? Not an anti-inflammatory, some sort of, what do they call drugs that, like when you've got arthritis, not a brand name of a drug, but I can't think, anti-something or other. Anyway, they prescribed them that, and they did find out, interestingly enough, they all came down with it exactly 3 days after they were exposed to it, which I've heard in two other instances now. So the 14-day quarantine rule may... Immunotherapy, thank you. May not be a thing. Who knows? But don't take my word for it, because I'm certainly not a doctor, although that would have made my parents very happy. They all survived and survived pretty well. And basically, they all had what felt like a cold. Even grandpa with immunotherapy. Like the stuff you would take for arthritis or if you had lupus or something like that. So interesting, you know, obviously can't take what happened to 6 out of 8 members of family and translate that into what would happen for everybody worldwide, but it's kind of encouraging. So there you go. So today we are going to continue listening to the rest of the music that we didn't get to listen to the other day, submitted by you guys. Question, have you used your UV light? Traveling use sounds perfect. Bed clothes to electronics, staying safe is great. Didn't bring the UV light with us. The battery in the thing will no longer take a charge, so I can only use it when it's plugged in. My shirt matches the blue painting. Actually, that blue painting was done by one of my daughters when she was, I don't know, maybe 12 years old or something like that. And it normally sits up there, but I had taken it down for Taxi TV because it kind of complicates the background over there. And then the other night, remember, we had company coming over, so I put it back up there because it just didn't seem right to have it sitting on the floor. So that's that. Thank you for the compliments to her. I switched from Izod to polo. Most of my shirts are polo. I've got a couple of Izods. That's right. The judge came over. Here come the judge. Yes, hit the like button, you guys. Please do that right now. And if you are not a subscriber to the channel, please subscribe. Tramadol. Oh man, that drug and I do not agree. Deb and I used to live back when we were still in the apartment back in the early to mid 90s. The guy who lived across the hall from us became a good friend, and he was an orthopedic surgeon. And he saw that I had back pain one day, and he said, let me bring you home some samples tomorrow of a drug that's non-narcotic and very easy to take. And it was tramadol. And I don't think I've ever had such a bad reaction to a drug in my life. Oh my gosh, the headaches. I mean, I was taking just one a day. You're supposed to take one like every 8 hours or something like that. And it gave me the kind of headache where you feel like somebody is driving a rusty railroad spike into your head using a sledgehammer. Nancy Kalel says, orange and blue are good on me. Okay. Well, there we go. Yeah, I do not like tramadol. Anyway, I'm sure it's wonderful for many other people, but not yours truly. So what do you say? Should we start listening to some music? I think if memory serves, the last thing we listened to the other day was Il Rosso Emil's percussion thing called Drum Boat, right? And is Randon ever on these quarantine-y happy hours? From time to time, not very often, especially when I have him as a guest, yes. And you love the Fallout Music Group plugins. They're the best, aren't they? And dirt cheap for what they are. Okay, so let's start. I'm going to put on my other headphone, earbud. And here we go. This is called Sun Arise by EMR. Here we go. Let me know if the level's okay.
Eyelids lift. You were shut for so long. I missed this. Together's where we belong. New day dawn. I march with you towards the light. The lights are on. Safety is inside. Sun arise, awaken us from slumber. Life awaits around the corner. Open your eyes. Open your eyes. Step outside. The streets are there to greet you.
Shoot, so sorry. I actually touched the phone, my bad. There we go. Very sorry.
Is
EMR. I have no idea who EMR is. People loved it. Who is EMR? The mystery submitter. Okay. All right, moving on. The next thing on the list, this is called Private Eye Instigator by Aaron Northern. All right. Aaron Northern, are you in the room? I don't believe that I've ever seen you in the chat room. Out yourself. Good job on that. Great job. A sneaky little dramedy cue. There's Aaron Northern. Hello. Good job. All right. Let me see. Running this playlist off my phone. Not optimal, I must say. All right. Okay, next one is called Tears of the Heart, and this is by Robert Martin. Thank you. Okay. Good job on that. All these new names on the list that I haven't seen yet. See, the problem is that it starts the next song on the playlist automatically. I should probably figure out how to not do that. And then when I go back to the top, if I'm in pause mode, it automatically starts playing. So, all right, this next one is called Playing Golf with My Dad. Is Cass McKenty in the room? Because this isn't from him. This is from Steve and Bruce. But we all know how Cass likes his golf. Very nice. And Debbie Ward sums it up perfectly by saying, I hope his dad got to hear this. Awesome. I agree. Speaking of golf, look, a new subject, not fishing. We're going to talk about golf. For my 50th birthday, Deb and I went to the same resort that we were at this past weekend for our anniversary. And for the weeks leading up to the birthday, there were times where I would call her on her cell phone and not be able to reach her. And being that I had a less than faithful wife first time around, my mind went to, oh no, do I have another wife having an affair? And so it was like a little disturbing. There were half a dozen times that I called her and didn't hear back from her for a couple of hours. Well, anyway, so we went to that resort. It was for my 50th birthday. And right next to the beautiful resort is a classic California golf course. And she said, as part of the package with the hotel, you get a round of golf if you choose that versus a dinner or something. So she said, come on, let's sign you up for golf and I'll just be a ride along. So I said, great. I don't think she'd ever seen me play golf, which she's probably better off having not seen that. Anyway, so on the first tee, right in front of the clubhouse, I get up there and I hit the ball and it's like a decent shot. And then my wife says, let me have your club. And I said, why? And she goes, let me have the club. I'm like, oh, no. Whoa, out of character for her. Thought she was going to beat me to death with it or something. So she takes the club. She takes a ball out of the little place in the cart where the balls go. And she walks up to the tee. She plants her feet. She wiggles her butt. And she hit the ball about 150 to 175 yards right up the middle of the first fairway. She turned around and said, "Happy birthday. I've been taking golf lessons so I could golf with you." So that's where she was. She was, when she was unreachable, she was taking lessons. So anyway, when we were walking around doing the beach walk the other day, we actually came upon one of the holes where you drive a ball off a cliff down onto a green that's right by the water. And we saw that, and it brought back that very nice memory. As a matter of fact, let's see if I can find the photo quickly. I will show you. Let me see now. There it is, right there. So see right in the middle of the picture, the green? That's where we golfed together 16 years ago. Aw. But we decided not to golf this past weekend. We were only there for literally 30 hours. Yeah, did you guys hear pilots landing at LAX today? Saw some guy flying around LAX wearing a jetpack. That's got to be the dumbest thing in the world. Flying around LAX, one of the busiest airports in the world, with a jetpack on. What an idiot. All right. Let me see if I can now get back to the music so we can continue on. And there we go. All right. The next one is called April Snow, and it's by Rennie Bear. Thank you. That was Rennie Bear. Somebody just said, who is this? So that was Rennie. Take a bow, Rennie. Those are incredibly fast fingers. Oh, man. All right. Very good. Okay, up next we have a song called, I'm not sure if it's a song actually or an instrumental, but it's called What It Was by Yuka and Michael Reschke. Get back to the top. Scott Hansen, definitely the funniest guy in the chat. He just wrote his own eulogy there. Sweet. All right. Riffs That Rule. Oh, you're in the room. I saw you earlier. There you are. This is Riffs That Rule playing Firestorm. Whoops. Yep. We'll be right back. Scott Hansen. First of all, incredible piece. Scott Hansen says, is that what they play at Guantanamo? Only for the first 30 days with the lights turned on and the cold water. Wow. Man, oh man, oh man. Even if those drums are programmed, that's impressive. But if that's live, even better. Whew. Peter Rahill, my new alarm clock sound. Yeah, that'll get you out of bed in the morning. By the way, Rahill, it was Sandpiper Golf Course in beautiful Goleta, which is a little bit north of Santa Barbara. Beautiful course. Used to be an A&R guy from Columbia Records named Marshall Altman, and he and I were very close friends for 7, 8, 9, 10 years, I don't know. And we would try and golf once a week together. And a couple of times we went up to that resort and took our wives and played golf. And it's just, it's a beautiful course. It's a playable course. That's the best part. It's a rewarding course. You can be a decent kind of mediocre golfer and feel like you know what you're doing on that course. Wow, the drums are programmed. Good job on that. Goleta. Gotta say, traffic going up there the other day was pretty thick coming back home. Nice. All right, let's move on. Okay, see if I can get this back to the top and paused, which I believe that I... No, I don't know why. Okay, this one is by Mark Reel, and it's called Too Cool to Fool.
So much more than this. Too cool to fool.
Well, that was some impressive guitar playing. Man, Steely Dan needs you. That was really impressive. Man, every time I get to the end of a song, it keeps taking me back to the top of the list. All right, moving on. Let's listen to This Is Greensleeves, What Child Is This by Marion Laird. Big finish. Great job, Marion. Was that all? You play the dulcimer, right? If I remember correctly. And by the way, whoever asked what my best golf shot is, absolutely a 30-foot chip. I'm really good at that, and that's about it. I hit them straight up the middle, but I'm not a long ball hitter. I chip really well. My fairway shots with my irons, they come and they go, and my putting, not so good. Anthony Dixon, how can I join Taxi? Go to taxi.com and click the button that says join. There you go. All right. Let's see. Scrolling back down the list again. All right. This one is called Angels by Lucian. Yeah, let me do this. Angels by Lucian Lewis. Mm-hmm. Whoa. That must have been the whole thing. It just stopped. I wasn't even touching the screen. Yeah, it's short. All right, well, that was Angels by Lucian Lewis. Sorry about that, but I was just looking at it, not even touching it, and it just stopped. Okay, moving on to another one here, which is Happy Birthday Tropical. Come on. Oh, he's, what a pain in the butt. Okay, let's try this one more time. Here we go. This is Happy Birthday Tropical by Jan Weilidge. That was another shorty. Okay, that was Happy Birthday Tropical by Jan Weilidge. I need to be more on top of my game here, apparently. Yeah, whoever asked, these were submitted last week just for the purpose of playing them on the show. We didn't screen them at all. This is just for the people in the chat room that have become regulars for the happy quarantine happy hours to hear each other's music so that they could maybe collaborate, things like that, and get to know each other better. All right. All right. This one is called We Gel by Ewart, or yeah, E-W-A-R-T Williams, a name I have not heard yet in the chat room. So hopefully you're in there. Thank you. Yeah. Hello, Ewart. Nice to meet you. No, have you been lurking all this time and never actually showed up in the chat? I want to know, which instruments did you play on that? Is that you on the sax, you on the keyboard, you on the guitar? All great players. We met, where, at the road rally? You're on piano. Wow, impressive. All right. Well, we've got one more in 2015 and 2016. Awesome. Well, nice to meet you again. Thank you for being present in the chat room and watching the quarantinis. And I want to give a special shout out to Scott Hansen for saying the word sax three times in the chat and getting the vowel correct. Nice going, Scott. All right, the last one is called, Caught in a Trap. Stay there. It won't do that. I take it all the way back and hit pause, and it just keeps going. All right, this one's called Caught in a Trap, and it's by Jay Williams. Ewart's tune was called We Gel, like W-E-E-G-E-L. That was Jay Williams, Caught in a Trap. I'm not saying, well, I guess it is funny, but the little rah, 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 dog bark thing is a true story. I was on a flight, a transcontinental flight. I think I was going to London like 15 years ago from Los Angeles. And, you know, those long flights, everybody's sleeping, the lights are turned down really low. There was a woman about two rows ahead of me and across the aisle, and she had this adorable little black Pomeranian that had its hair cut, and the thing looked like a little miniature bear about this big. And in the middle of the flight, I mean, it was really dark in the cabin of the plane, I got up to go hit the restroom, and her dog was in the aisle, and I stepped on it. And every time I heard that, rah, 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 it reminded me of that night. Thank God I didn't break anything. The dog was fine. It was so embarrassing. The whole rest of the flight, every time that lady would see me, she'd give me the stink eye. Anyway, all right, we are wrapped up. 501, if I hadn't told my dopey little story about stepping on a Pomeranian somewhere over the Atlantic, we would have been done at 5 o'clock, right? Anyway, thank you all for submitting. I know it's really, you know, it takes a lot of bravery to submit music that's going to be played in front of a bunch of other musicians. And that takes courage. I'm really proud of you guys. Thankful for your participation in this. Really glad that we could do it and everybody could hear everybody else's music. What? Scott Hansen saying something serious? Oh, wow. You're getting a golden retriever pup. Yeah. They're replacing you, Scott, with something that's easier to get along with. But it'll never be as funny as you are. Oh, man. All right. I will see you guys tomorrow for another exciting episode of Taxi's Quarantini Happy Hour. We'll be back with more fun and games. Don't forget to give us a like. Don't forget to subscribe if you're not a subscriber already. And if you would be so kind, pop in the comments in about 10 or 15 minutes once it's up in the archives. Give me some ideas for topics or questions for tomorrow's show, and we will see you then. Bye-bye, you guys. Have a great night.